Advanced alignment. ZW3D 2016 provides some new alignment types, such as middle alignment and frame alignment. Mechanical alignment is also available now. Let's look at some examples. This is a simple assembly model. Hold down the left mouse button and drag to move the picked component. The left jack catch component moves within a certain range. The right jack catch component can move to any position along this groove. Now, let's add a middle alignment for these two components. Then define base entities. Select the end faces of the clamp groove. Pick the outside end face of the jack catch component to be the center entity. Then, drag the left component to check the assembly movement. Here is another case. Firstly, turn off local datum and turn on external datum. Then do frame alignment. Pick any datum of one component and pick the corresponding datum of another one. Now, this is the result. All corresponding datums are aligned. In the previous version, we need to do three coincident constraints to align these two components. In ZW3D 2016, we can easily align them. Last, let's look at a mechanical assembly. This is a rack and pinion assembly. Check the movement first. Rack moves along the X direction. The pinion rotates about its central axis. They do not move together. Click the mechanical align feature. Select rack and pinion alignment. Pick a circle and a line to stand for these two components. Then define the suitable parameters. Click OK to finish. Drag the rake, pinion, and rack to move together. Thus, the mechanical alignment is done.